Today is a very special day because it is the birthday of Mama Mary, the mother of Jesus, and our very own mother too. It's Sister Jennifer once again, and welcome to Campus Ministry Vlogs. We Dominicans have a special devotion to the Blessed Virgin Mary. In this vlog, we're going to tell you the reasons why we have Mama Mary as the special patroness of our order. But before that, let us answer this stereotype question. Is Mama Mary a god or a goddess that you adore her? First, the Blessed Virgin Mary is a human being like us. She is neither a god nor a goddess, but she has been granted a special privilege of being sinless and full of grace in her lifetime from the moment of her conception. Thus, the dogma of the Immaculate Conception, which we celebrate every December 8, pertains to St. Anne's, that is, Mama Mary's mother, conceiving the Blessed Virgin Mary in her womb. That is why, from December 8, if we count 9 months after, a baby girl was born on September 8, that is today, the birth of Mama Mary. Again, the Immaculate Conception is not Mama Mary having Jesus in her womb. That one is called virginal conception. The Immaculate Conception means that the Blessed Virgin Mary was conceived in the womb of her mother, Saint Anne, free from original sin, because she was destined to be the mother of our Lord Jesus Christ. Second, we do not adore nor worship the Blessed Virgin Mary. Just like the saints, we venerate her, we give her honor, and we ask for her prayers. Remember, when we call on God, we plead for mercy. But when we call on the saints and Mama Mary, we ask for their prayers. Lord Jesus, have mercy on us. Mama Mary, pray for us. Saint Dominic, pray for us. Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, pray for us. Our love for the Blessed Virgin Mary is quite obvious in what we wear. Most Dominican religious like us wear our habit with a scapular and with a rosary hanging from our belts. At the beginning of the order, the Dominican habit did not have a scapular. At that time, a well-known priest, Master Reginald of Orleans, wanted to join the order of preachers. Then, he suddenly became desperately ill, but a miracle cured him. During the height of one of his fevers, the Virgin Mary visibly appeared to him and anointed him. Then he showed him the complete habit of the order. At once, he became well. Through this vision, the Blessed Virgin Mary gave the Dominican order the white scapular as a sign of her maternal protection. Since then, we wear our habit with the white scapular. As for the rosary, if you have joined us in the third room prayers in honor of Saint Dominic, it was mentioned in the reading for the third day why the Dominicans promote the rosary and eventually made it part of the habit. But his preaching was not always successful. According to tradition, Saint Dominic was distressed at his lack of success in his preaching in countering the heresy, and in his desperation, turned to the Mother of God for help. She appeared to him and told him to use her Psalter or the Hail Mary in his preaching of the mysteries of our salvation as an instrument in combating the great heresy of his day. Thus, Saint Dominic began to promote the prayer of the rosary. Aside from these special gifts of white scapular and rosary given by the Blessed Mother to the order, she also granted us, through Saint Dominic, her special blessing and protection. When I was not yet a sister and it was my first time to spend the night in the convent, I heard some noise outside my door after the night prayer. These voices seem to be uttering prayers. I didn't bother at first, but on my second night, I listened attentively at the voices as I stood near my door. They were praying the Hail Mary. When I became a sister, I learned more about this practice. I've read about it as recorded from the exposition of the Constitutions of the Order of Preachers by Blessed Humbert of Romans. One night, after continuing his prayers until midnight, Dominic left the church and came to the dormitory. He completed what he had to do, and taking his place at one end of the dormitory, continued to pray. As he stood praying, he glanced at the other end of the dormitory and saw three beautiful women enter. He noticed that the one in the middle was a venerable lady, far more beautiful and dignified than the other two. One of them was carrying a beautiful shiny vessel and the other an aspersorium that she handed to the lady in the center. She went from bed to bed, sprinkling the brethren with holy water and blessing them. The lady said to Saint Dominic, "I am the one you call upon in the evening. When you say, 'Turn therefore, most gracious advocate, thine eyes of mercy toward us,' I prostrate myself before my son and ask him to preserve the order." After this, the lady, who was the Blessed Mother herself, continued to sprinkle and bless all the others, and then disappeared. That is why we, Dominicans, have the practice of having one or two sisters blessing each room every night after our night prayers, praying the Hail Mary as we do so. Another story inscribed in the records of the order was that, after this vision of Saint Dominic, he returned to pray in the place he stood before. Suddenly, he was wrapped in spirit before God, and saw our Lord and the Blessed Virgin sitting at his right. It seemed to Saint Dominic that Our Lady was wearing a cape of bright blue, the color of sapphire. As Saint Dominic looked around, he could see religious of all the orders before the throne of God, except the Dominican order. He began to weep bitterly and stood far away. Our Lord told him to rise and then asked him, "Why are you weeping?" Dominic said, "I am weeping because I see all the other orders here, but there is no sign of my own." The Lord said to him, "Do you want to see your order?" Dominic answered, "Yes, Lord." Then our Lord, putting his hand upon the shoulders of the Blessed Virgin, said to Saint Dominic, "I have entrusted your order to my mother." Then the Blessed Virgin opened the cape that covered her and spread it out before Saint Dominic. It seemed vast enough to cover the entire heaven, and under it he saw a large multitude of his brothers and sisters of the Order of Preachers. Then, prostrating himself, Saint Dominic gave thanks to God and to the Blessed Mary. After that, the vision disappeared and he returned to himself just as the bell rang for midnight prayers. Another tradition that we have is the singing of the Salve Regina or the Hail Holy Queen in Latin after completing our night prayer in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary. According to Blessed Jordan of Saxony, in his writings in the beginnings of the Order of Preachers, this tradition began after the death of Saint Dominic. There was a brother in Bologna called Bernard who was plagued by a most savage demon to such an extent that he was driven day and night by horrible seizures of madness, which caused no end of disturbance to the other brothers. Brother Bernard's fierce tribulation was the occasion which prompted them to decide for the first time to sing the Salve Regina with the procession after complaint in Bologna. Immediately, peace was restored to the monastery. The practice of the Salve procession spread rapidly from there, and to the rest of the province in Lombardy. And finally, the same devout and beneficial practice was adopted throughout the whole Dominican order, as well as to other religious orders in the church. A dependable religious once told Blessed Jordan that he had often seen in spirit, while the brothers are saying Ea ergo advocata nostra, or turn then most gracious advocate, the Blessed Virgin Mary prostrating herself or kneeling before the presence of her son and praying for the safety of the order. Dominican life is marked by Marian devotion. We wear her scapular, pray and promote her rosary, and daily seek her intercession. We have the privilege of being under Mama Mary's mantle, with a blessing every night in the singing of the Salve Regina, having the Queen as our advocate to her Son, our Lord. What more can a Dominican ask for? Most importantly, Mama Mary is the special patroness of the order because she is the model Dominican, one who contemplated the Word in her heart and who lived to praise, to bless, and to preach God's goodness. Happy birthday, Mama Mary! Thank you for taking care of us.